So my first impression is very religious is the game, seems like, but I don't know. I'm just gonna tap out for a second. I need to be able to keep track of what's happening on screen, sorry. So, it seems like it's pretty standard attacks. You have primary, secondary attack. And I put this to max graphics. So if we have a lot of frame stuttering and stuff like that, then we know that this game runs worse than Elden Ring. So let's just play the demo. Let's see what happens. Hopefully this is not like a super long demo. Why does it say weapon up, weapon left, weapon right, and then not the sign? What's going on there? I don't know. Oh yeah, I forgot to bring out a drink. I'll bring out a drink before we play Cold Rain. So let's see here. Hopefully these like not assigned things is gonna not ruin the entire game. So that's the girl I saw in the trailer with a big sword.
Something's coming. What is that? Oh no, I won't. Not again.
Sister, stay with me. Don't get in.
So this is 30 FPS, so this is pre-rendered, pretty sure.
Damn.
I would totally haunt my sister if I was dead. Am I supposed to click anything?
Yes, despite my weakness.
That power was immense. It's not your fault.
Then whose fault is it? You saw. I almost... If I gave in to the corruption inside me, you'd be lost. I won't allow it.
You resisted. No other Chimera could have done that.
No other Chimera with a damned corrupted as a knight, you mean.
Sister, that was an insanely powerful aura. And there's something else.
An issue here is, like, you can't autoplay this. Like, you have to click every time someone new speaks. Like, I hate this. This is something Japanese games do. I hate this. Like, just autoplay the cutscene.
I could sense there were two Chimeras at the source. I felt their strain, their suffering. They pushed themselves to their limits. It was like a scream in my head. But then all of a sudden, they were gone.
Both of them. Are you certain?
I can't sense either of them now. And the other aura, it's gone too.
Not for good, I wager.
We might be the only ones left to fight it.
Be on guard then. We may have to deal with it sooner or later.
So, this has forced perspective, so I can't control the camera. So it's kind of like old school style. God of War. And the dodge key is the same as Nier Autonoma. Let's see, what can we do? So let's jump. Hit. Yeah, I still don't have any camera control. So it has combos. Okay. Breakable terrain that drops money. Okay, so it is Dark God of War Devil May Cry style, I guess, I would say.
You think too much, Luke.
So I don't see a slam. No. So this game is not about slamming, it's about air juggling then, I guess? Is there items in boxes? No, not really. So it's focusing in on this. So in the real game we could probably have done something there. Who knows? I'm not gonna bore you guys with like destroying all the boxes when we're not even playing the real game. What is this? If a localization field loot isn't to interact with an eternal object, but on physical. If you press left trigger, loot activated the evacuator, causing an ethereal object in the vicinity to manifest. Entropy, calling entropy field, cause entropy to increase, however, loot to decrease. For any reason. I don't get it, and I don't have time to read it.
We can shatter them if we work together. Let me focus my energy.
So left trigger.
I'm fading away.
So it never told me that I was supposed to hit it. Well, it probably did. I'm not gonna read. I'm sorry. Like, if your game needs tutorials right there, 2 seconds in, and I'm like, I don't want to read. I want to hit stuff. I'm such a child. I've been playing too many Souls games where you have to figure everything out yourself, and like, you get to like 9 dungeons in and you don't even know. An invisible wall here, I don't like that. They should just put a gate here. Yeah, I've been playing like Elden Ring and Code Vein, and like in Elden Ring, like I was like 4 or 5 dungeons in. Oh, we have camera control. So let's see if we can air juggle. Kinda. So there's a clunkiness to the combat, I'm not gonna lie. Like, for example, when I hit the entire screen moves for some reason. I was using, but this game has for some reason put light attack. Unity presents a connection between prey and loot. The higher their harmony, the greater their efficiency to fight together. The indication In upper right corner of the screen shows lever Bryolus. As you fight, you can gain or lose unity. Offense, defense are both involved in process, successfully combining Lute's abilities to increase unity while being hit or knocked back. Race of the Highness units strengthen the bond when they confess. The sister can unleash devastating synergy attacks, trying to execute the alternative combo of your Ash and Vigor. The first assault synergy can unlock synergy attacks from the Lute's power menu. Okay. So we don't even have the synergy you're asking me to use. Yeah, so this game has put the power attack on the Y key and the heavy attack on, I don't know what it is on an Xbox, the X key. Which is completely the opposite to all of these games, but you can change it, so. So I'm wondering if there's combos I missed. Okay, so every time you do a fight, apparently you get scored. And I got scored platinum, apparently. I don't know if that's good. And now they locked my camera again, and it's behind an object. Why not just let me control the camera all the time? Like, forced perspective hasn't been popular since God of War did it, so why are you doing it? So blur loot. Can we do stuff here? Piercing launch, move forward. Will I get this, I guess? Oh, we can't get that because we already have that. Okay. What is this? So this is the hammer. Oh, there we have the slam attack ice I was talking about earlier. Swirling off burst, so that looks cool as well. Just get this. It makes these games more fun if you can launch. It says I have enough money, but I'm not allowed to unlock it, I guess. Like, it says I have 4 grand in the bottom there. Fields. So if you guys see on the down right there, there's two types of money. One for the ghost and one for me. Like, I'm wondering if, is there a special key? Like, it should just be X, right? But it isn't X. No? Okay, whatever. Maybe you can only unlock skills at, like, a special point? So it's really distracting that
the gods seal the gates, trapping the people inside. They tried to contain the corrupted and failed.
So it's kind of distracting that you can't... that all the cutscenes are pre-rendered at 30 FPS and then the rest of the game runs at over 100 FPS. So every time a cutscene starts, like, your brain lags, if you guys know how that works. If you ever had anything... Oh, there's a thing there. Oh, so you get money for a ghost by finding those crystals, by paying attention, okay. And you find money for the human by just killing everything and every thing on the map, apparently. Yeah, if you modify the controls for this game so you get the heavy attack on the heavy thing, this will feel like familiar to anyone who has played God of War. The only difference is that if you played God of War, you probably have died by now. I played the God of War 1 recently and it's not as easy as the newer games, I'm gonna be honest. Okay, so this guy has levels up the skills. S, X to acquire. Then we need to go to loot and see offensive. So we only have stasis. I guess we get stasis. I don't care, it's a demo. We're trying stuff out.
May the shaper guide your hand.
So what I'm thinking is that in the real game they're probably gonna explain that dude and why he's here. Yeah. Okay, your character is so tiny in this. Like, you're so far away from the camera. It's very hard to see. I have to, like, move my head forward almost.
One down.
Okay, let's try that combo. So it's forward and Y. Well, not really. Yeah, the stab thing didn't work. Yeah, like I said, having 30 FPS cutscenes... So I pressed dodge there multiple times and it locked me into some ghost event. So that was the stasis thing we just unlocked.
This is good. Intense.
Yeah. It feels super clunky. And I don't mean clunkiest in like a Soulstice game's clunky. I mean like every time you hit, it feels like the game does a slow-mo move. Like it, every time I hit a slice, it feels like it goes slow-mo for a couple of seconds and it doesn't feel good. And the stasis ability just made it harder to memorize the guy's moveset. Because after the stasis is over, he just swings. So I have to figure out how long my stasis is. Yeah. Another invisible wall.
Sister, a powerful aura was here. It left traces, like an echo.
What was it?
I can't tell, but those traces may just let us see what happened.
Yeah, the 30 FPS cutscenes are really ugly, I'm gonna be honest.
Like, never seen the knights acting like this before.
But it goes back to 140, it's a lot better.
Me neither. Whatever's in there must be really valuable.
You try to steal it then. I'm staying here.
And this should just play. You shouldn't have to press the button every time.
Shut up, they'll hear you.
Soldiers, the next one of you who speaks will be flogged. The one after that will be hung. The one after that, courted. Have I made myself clear?
Like, if people want to skip your cutscenes, then you have to let them skip your cutscenes with the start button. Don't press, do you have to skip every single sentence? Like, I like watching cutscenes, and even I think that's annoying.
Easy now, easy. Not my choice to come this way, is it? I like it no more than you do. Settle down.
Even the animals were restless.
They could sense the danger too.
Halt! In the name of the Triarchy and the Shining City of Ilden! The Ashen Blade. Huh. What is your business here?
We carry a gift. From the Grand Master of the Order to the High Clergy of Ilden.
Is that all?
We are expected at the Cathedral of Guiding Light.
We had no advance notice of your arrival. You can't just show up and...
Our papers speak for themselves. Here. Now let us in, if you care for your useless job.
It's well voice acted, but... What function does this fill?
Just let them in! It's not worth dying for!
Are the entire story gonna be told like this, with just ghosts that are standing still?
Fine. Good sir. Of course. You may pass. May the Torchbearer light your way.
Well, this is the City of Light, is it not?
Now I understand. The aura I feel. The one that left this echo. Came from inside that armored carriage.
Can you tell me what was inside?
I can't see inside. The carriage is lined with something. It's dulling my perception, so this was done on purpose. By someone who knows the Order, who knows its secrets.
You mean us? The Chimeras?
I think so. That carriage is at the heart of whatever happened here.
Then we have to find it.
And soon. Whatever it's doing here might not be finished.
You guys notice how unnatural they speak? Because I have to press X every time I want to move on in a conversation. Like, is there a way to fix that? This I don't want done. That was really annoying. Let's see, when enable gameplay assist will be available, note that gameplay is activated, note will be displayed in chapter scores. Yeah, I just want you to play voice acting naturally, but seems like you don't want that to be a thing. Yeah, there's no way to fix that. Well, that's it. So you're now teaching me. So we have to destroy this one as fast as possible. Okey-dokey.
There may be no one here, but I'm not letting my guard down.
So me falling off a bridge there was actually good. If this was the real game, which it isn't, so we're moving on. I didn't check if you could change this to PlayStation prompts. That would also be cool, but I don't expect that to be a thing. And I played so many of like games on controller, on PlayStation controller, on PC, that I know how that works anyway. It's easier, like you saw there. Hi, Misty! I'm just trying out the game here, a demo. I don't know if I'm very impressed with it. Like, if you look here, like, it feels like the entire game is going in slow motion every time you hit, and it's very hard to, like, feel like it's smooth. Like, for a spectrical fighter like this, I feel like this should be smooth. So let's just see if there's a boss fight.
Crystal Cluster. This shouldn't be here, so
So banishment field, if you press R3, you will action banishment field. This is also too much text for a tutorial.
We need to get past it. Simple. We just need to combine sword and spirit. Sister, let me help. We can do this.
So, how are you doing today, Misty? I only like slow-mo if it's like, you know, done like in Doom 2016 or whatever, when like it's done just as a special time or whatever. So let's see, it's an actual cutscene now. And a boss fight, hopefully. Yeah, I agree. That's what I've been saying. It just, when there's slow-mo on every single attack, like, it makes the game feel clunky. Wraiths are foes that look like Shape of Chaos itself. Okay, so you have to use...
Now you've pissed me off. Hundreds must have come through the tear.
Also, you can see how, like, you can see how the ghost, this one right in the middle of the screen, is freezing the enemies, and it's freezing the enemies in the middle of their attacks, and then when the freeze is over, the enemy swipes me, and I'm like, it's easier if the ghost doesn't freeze my attacks, so I feel like I made a mistake picking that ability. let's see here. I'm doing good. Pretty good. Just push new gun plus in cold vein a very bit. Very nice. Yeah, I was thinking I was gonna play cold vein after this, which you've probably seen in the title. I ate my diet food today, so my stomach is like, why did you eat something healthy? Why didn't you do the right thing and just eat the unhealthy food? You know how it is. So we can level up here.
Dear sisters.
It was so much easier when I just ate garbage. Yeah, so we have a level up point when we haven't earned enough points to level anything up. Let's see here. What can we unlock? Luther's Barrier counter parries attack with medium or high enemies too. I didn't even know you could parry. So it seems like she is auto parrying stuff, I guess. Let's just unlock a bunch of stuff. I don't want to sit and do this while... We have other things to do after this. Oh, I should have gotten an ability in here, maybe. Yeah, probably. What type of a diet are you on, Misty?
May the torch better light your way.
So does this give me anything? A large sum of money.
Place like this is a feast for wraiths.
Yes, I used to eat less and more greens. So it's the same as me. So we needed 6,000 for something, right? Yeah, there we go. Soaring ascent. No, that's the thing. I don't want that, though.
You know how to find me.
Yeah. As I've said earlier, in earlier streams, I ate my first vegetables when I hit 30. And I'm not lying when I say that. Like, a lot of people are lying, but before 30, I ate no vegetables at all. So the camera angle here is really annoying. I'm just trying to get enough money to buy that attack so we can see how it is. Because this game is probably going to be over soon.
Do you ever wonder what we might have been?
There's no use in looking behind us, Lud.
So we're pretty close. Yeah, I hate most vegetables. I've, not eaten a lot of it. Wait, this just leads to an empty room? The diet I'm on right now, I'm eating broccoli mixed with corn and mixed with peas every day, and then I switch out the meat product with it. Which is probably gonna make a lot of people mad that I eat meat products, but I don't care. I've been flamed all my life for eating meat, so...
I wish that killing could come to an end.
Unfortunately, it's all I'm good for now.
Yeah, I went to textile school and no one ate meat, and I got frozen out of all the friend groups, and it kind of sucked, and people were mad. So you guys see how ugly the game looks when the cutscenes go into 30 FPS from 130? I know you guys only see 60 FPS, but... But you know what I mean. This is just a demo, guys, so I'm gonna talk over the characters. They talk so much anyway. Like, I don't really care. I'm sorry if you don't like that. And this is something I don't like about the game. I can't see the character right now. The character is way too small. Like, Why is the camera all the way over here? And why can I do this? Why not just let me have the camera behind the character? Like, why is the camera on another part of the planet? So let's see the first boss fight, I guess. Fight me. Okay, so he took no damage. Do you guys see how like my character stop every time I dodge? And then the boss runs away. Wraiths also twist corrupt host of the souls, the possessed of our prayers. Yeah, I was using the banishment field. I'm not stupid. Yeah, so this is like fighting the Elden Ring beast where it just runs away every time you come close to it, which is really annoying, I'm gonna be honest. Like this is the boss fight you show in your demo? Nah, this game. And you have to hold the button for everything in the menu. No, this game, I'm not buying that. I don't even have the money for it. I'm not buying that on launch. The fact that the character gets like stuck on the ground after you use the dodge button and the enemies run away from you. No, no. Let's switch to Cold Vein, guys. That game. Like, I love Spectrical Fighters. I love playing Nier. I love playing God of War. That game, no, fuck that.